there is actually no stunt and there is a various amount of food as
well. A 3-hour trip to the city would have led to an inevitable amputation. Dr. Jitendra Patel from Boisar contacted his mentor Dr. Patel in Rajavari Hospital in Mumbai and guided him throughout the 10-hour long grueling surgery via WhatsApp.
I think that's been saving our child's life.
Thanks to telemedicine, this story has a happy ending.
Presenting Healing Bio.
90% of the Indians live outside the 10 towns of India. Ratio of doctor patient in the third world countries is less than 1:2000. 98% of the specialists and super specialists live in the top 10 towns of India. Over 1 billion people in the world with limited access to specialists and super specialists. So how do we change this now? How do we multiply our doctor's presence? How do we provide instant medical care? How do we extend the reach of specialists across the globe? Can a solution exist? Yes, friends, it indeed does. Health today is just a click away. Making healthcare accessible through technology. Introducing telemedicine. The World Health Organization defines telemedicine as the delivery of healthcare services where distance is a critical factor by all healthcare professionals.
Infrastructure. Also, consider the technical constraints, especially in the areas which are practically impenetrable.
With the rising mobile and internet penetration spurred on by the Digital India campaign, technology is reaching even the far-flung areas. Also, the Indian Space Research Organization launched a satellite, GrandSat, for even the remotest and poorly accessible areas.
And what about the legal issues? Who would be held liable in a medical legal case?
Well, the doctor and the patient end would be held liable. Also, the Department of Information Technology has recommended guidelines and protocols for the practice of telemedicine in India.
When you go to a hospital, a compassionate expert understands your problem. But with telemedicine, how do you successfully establish a doctor-patient relationship?
Well, in reality, doctors are often rushed in the frantic environment of the OPDs and they are unable to explain conclusions to the patients. Finally, telemedicine is a better way of getting our doctor's care and attention. No technology can replace the skills and intelligence of a doctor. But with the joint venture of physicians and technology, we can work towards achieving our ultimate goal. Quality healthcare for all. This alone, we can make a difference. But together, we can make a change.
From the extensive anonymous survey of a large sample of 634 people conducted by us across 13 Indian cities, we found that an overwhelming 87% of the general public believe that telemedicine will help in saving their time. 77% say it will be cost effective, and a huge 80% believe that it will provide better access to healthcare. Every second individual is of the opinion that even via telemedicine, a good doctor-patient relationship can be established. Among the doctors surveyed, 3/4 believe that it will help in controlling fatalities. A vast majority of doctors agree that it is useful in providing primary health care, specialist consultation, second opinion, and health education. 80% said that they would recommend this service to their patients. 4 out of 5 medical students agree that web lectures are a novel method of learning.
1965, the White Revolution. 1968, the Green Revolution. 2000, the IT Revolution. 2015, the Healthcare Revolution. And telemedicine is now revitalizing the Indian healthcare system. Technological advancements like the digital stethoscope, StetIO, B-Scan, and BARC Tandem tele-ECG machine are empowering us to push the boundaries of what's possible, thereby facilitating telemedicine.
In all the fields, for example, be it pediatrics, pharmacology, psychiatry, we can use telemedicine in each and every field. So that was what basically they wanted to explain, and they made a comprehensive definition about telemedicine.
So congratulations on a topic of great relevance and interest and well presented. One small suggestion for your future use: you should have been a little more aware of the mic for the speakers. It was a little far away for some of you. That's one suggestion for future.
Yes.
And the other thing was, you did mention that it would have been good if you had mentioned more details about your particular study. You just spoke in percentages, but you did give more details about how, what, when, and where. Right.
Well presented. The same person should like to ask you, what is your role in this particular study? What is that which you have done? That's the first question. And second thing is, which department you think has got more relevance for tele and
stuff? Thank you for your question, sir. So firstly, I'd like to answer your second question. All departments have an equal relevance in telemedicine. It has been proved because Apollo Hospitals, in fact, is in the forefront of telemedicine, and they are using it for almost all the fields. Secondly, our role was basically, we did a lot of groundwork. One of the things that we did is we started our own pilot project. We got in touch, like we mentioned in our presentation, we got in touch with Dr. Pandurang Chavri, who manages a PNC in a village called Bima Mansur. And we started, when we spoke to him, he told us that he had a lot of problems in diagnosing dermatology cases because he wasn't well aware of these cases. So we thought we linked, since he had a problem specifically with dermatology cases, we linked him to the dermatologist in Thane from our college. And it turned out to be really great because the patients really benefited a lot. Unfortunately, it was a pilot project and our ethics committee had given us permission only for a couple of months. So it couldn't continue for a long time, but it was definitely successful. And Dr. Chavri is of the opinion that it really helped him a lot. So he's actually going to talk to the other medical officers in the adjacent villages and get in touch with us and actually think of starting this on a permanent basis.
Very good presentation, and I have one question. If you are given a choice between regionalization of care versus universal of telemedicine, which one you will choose?
I'm sorry, sir, I didn't really understand your question.
If you want to choose between regionalization of care, you understand regionalization of care?
Yes.
Versus telemedicine, which one you will choose?
I'd like to answer this question with an example.
So in regionalization of care, you have BHC, CHC,
yes.
Tertiary care hospitals.
Yes.
So that is a missing link in our country now. You have systems, but they're not running well.
Right.
So between the system which is already existing versus you want to develop a new system by which the private care or the doctors in the super specialist going to the villages and to the districts, how do they help? So that is telemedicine. So between these two, which you want to prefer?
So actually, we can use a combination of both. We can establish a telemedicine center in the primary, like we did in our pilot project.
Very good answer. It is telemedicine, which regionalization of care is the answer. Good.
A very good presentation.
Thank you.
Mine is only one question related with your study. Have you discussed the logistics related with your study with the doctors whom you are interacting with?
Yes, ma'am. And we also noticed that the younger generation of doctors were more receptive to the concept of telemedicine rather than the older generation. But once we did our pilot project, we actually proved a point and everybody did agree that it can work. Yes, it will take a little effort on our part, but it's for the greater good and we need to start somewhere. So, thank you, ma'am.
I enjoyed the presentation because so much of it has come from my organization, right? And I enjoyed your answers very much. You really got on the spot, so So we also feel, see, presentation also means thinking on your feet, which you have done. Just wanted to add on what Dr. talked about. Bhutan is an example where it has been done exactly. The whole country has been converted for telemedicine along with the regionalization, and they have done very well. So next time when you want to improve on this presentation or another contest you have, you can bring in Bhutan, and the whole country has been covered with that. Thank you very much once again. Very well done.
Running costs for a telemedicine center are very low, it's minimal. So it's definitely the next best alternative.